a warning for our Queensland viewers. This next story is distressing. They were done, defeated, until they weren't. The Penrith Panthers crowned this year's NRL Premiers for the third time running.
Get into it, Josh.
Snatching victory from the jaws of defeat. Yada, yada, yada. One of the greatest games. We'll take the package.
Put your hands together. Watch a game for your Penrith Panthers.
We drove 3 hours to get here. I'm just a mad Panthers supporter.
It was something else. It was completely something else. Yeah. I don't know what else to say.
Penrith all the way, always, for the rest of my life.
Penrith in full party mode after the Panthers pulled off the greatest comeback in grand final history.
It's 24-20.
Nathan Cleary securing a place among the greats.
It goes to Cleary. Nathan Cleary! Oh! Wow! What a try!
Down 16 points with less than 20 minutes on the clock.
Just elevated himself to grand final.
Defeating the Brisbane Broncos 26-24.
We're down but we're never out. We keep fighting. That's our mentality. And...
yeah! The first team in 40 years to win three premierships back to back to back.
Three, baby!
Sending the West wild. They tooted. They screamed. While Mick Fanning kindly offered up some post-match analysis.
Oh, this is the best thing ever. Oh, my God, this is so amazing.
The Panthers, well, they partied too. Their fans full of Panther pride.
What a comeback that was last night.
Let little Nate do all the work.
Declaring they're just getting started.
We can make four in a row, I know it.
Just getting started. It's the stuff of nightmares. NRL legend Benny Elias joins me for my counselling session. Benny, how stupid's football?
Oh, look, isn't it cruel? You know, the emotions that you have, the emotions, whether they're joyous or very depressing, it was. It had it all last night, that's for sure. It was an absolute cracker of a game. I thought the first half was very only okay, but the second half, my goodness gracious, you had never seen rugby league played like that ever again. It was just absolutely breakneck, and you just did not know who was going to win until the last hurdle went.
Well, the thing is, you thought you did. Mm. Like, the commentators were even talking about, oh, Brisbane, what a great premiership. Mm. How many can they win from here? And then suddenly, we're like, where would you rank this among the best grand finals of all time?
Oh, look, it's got to be up there with the best of them, without a doubt, you know. When you have a side 16 points down with 20 minutes to go and you think that there's no way in the world that they're going to get beat from here, and they did the unbelievable.
Well, Benny, while you're ranking things, does this cement Penrith as the greatest team ever?
Well, look, they've just been in four grand finals. They've won three of them. The Parramatta Eels in the early 80s were the last side to win three in a row, and before that was the great, great St George side back when they won 11 premierships in a row.
So, 11 in a row! They're not going to get near them.
But look, they are looking strong. They've got a dynasty out there in Penrith. Penrith is the mecca centre of Sydney and if not New South Wales now, and they just love their rugby league. They were down and out and they thought the game had gone. And then enter Cleary comes into the scene and, oh, my goodness gracious, you know, for a kid 25 years of age, his best football's ahead of him. And that is the frightening part there for all the opposition because this kid, Nathan Cleary, is just absolutely out of the world.
The Panthers were very impressive, but the Broncos were so close.
Thank you.
And they were very close, but they made some errors. They've got to have some regrets. What do you think they are, Benny? What's with these short dropouts they kept going for?
Oh, look, well, that's spot on. I mean, for the life of me, in a grand final, you're really throwing the dice and doing the short kickoff when it was nil all. Panthers scored the try and took charge, and then again they tried it again and they kicked it out in the full. So, look, the line dropouts was certainly a major factor for the Broncos. I think take that away, they win that premiership yesterday, without a doubt.
Oh, that's a huge call.
Wow.
That decisive.
So it's very Adam hard. Reynolds' fault.
Harsh but true.
Oh, wow.
No. You can't blame old.
You can't say something and then just walk away from the implications, mate. It doesn't work that way. Hey, here's what I don't quite get, Benny. This is a great team. Yeah. You've said it. Nathan Cleary. I mean, he's probably already going to be an immortal. That's how good he is. Luai, I know he was injured yesterday, but through the finals, incredible player. Isaiah Yeo. All these guys play for New South Wales. If Penrith are so great, why New South Wales so crap?
Oh, come on, mate.
Ooh.
Oh, now, come on. Exactly. You have to be nasty. You're taking away a little bit of our joyous season and bringing in the state of origin.
Why do you want to
ruin this interview? This is good. It's going so great. It was a great victory. And I've got to say, what I will say, team, I tell you what I will say. I felt for the Broncos yesterday, leaving Acor Stadium last night after the game. I saw the Broncos. A lot of the kids were in tears. It was the Cinderella story, wasn't it? Getting to the grand final and having all Queensland there backing them up. And just unfortunately, it just didn't happen for them because the might of the great Panthers, as we've said, it was one of the great grand finals of all time. Also, complemented by the day before with the AFL. Australia has been blessed to be treated with two great grand finals. And unfortunately for up there, Queensland, you didn't win. Ha!
Well, Benny, look, it wasn't just the children that were crying. It was women over a certain age as well. A few tears shed from me. This counselling session has somehow made me more depressed. Benny Elias, thank you so much for your time.
No.
Cheers, Benny.
Cheers. Always good to see you.